Love begins at home. How does it begin? By praying together. Family that prays together stays together. And if we stay together, naturally, we will love one another as God loves each one of us. We all know that. No one can say, I don't know. But it's necessary for us to put that love in a living action. And so Jesus has taught us, I was hungry to give it to you. Not only hungry for a piece of bread, hungry for love, to be wanted, to be somebody to somebody. That little unborn child, hungry for love, and is unwanted, unloved, rejected. Naked, I was naked, and you clothed me. Not only with a piece of cloth, but nakedness, loss of that dignity, loss of that beautiful gift of God, purity, chastity, virginity. Homeless, not only for a home made of bricks, but homelessness and being rejected, unwanted, unloved, just like that. I'll never forget, I was walking down the street of London one day, we have our sisters there, and I saw a man in the most terrible condition sitting there, looking so sad, so rejected, so down. So I went right up to him and I took his hand and I shook his hand and I asked him how he was. He looked up and he said, Weeks ago, two young people came to our house and they gave me lots of money. And I asked them, where did you get so much money? And the two of them said, 2 days ago, we got married. And before marriage, we decided that we will not buy wedding clothes. We will not have wedding feast. We will give you the money. I know what it means for a Hindu family not to have wedding feast and so on. I was very greatly surprised. So I asked another question, why did you do like that? And they said, we loved each other so much that we wanted to share the joy of loving asking you to make, to share with Jesus. Then you will know how Jesus loves you now. How he loves you. And how he wants you to love one another as he loves you. Him. With tenderness and love. See the little vine. So strong. And yet God chose that little unborn child to be the first one to recognize Jesus. When our baby came into the home of Elizabeth, the little one in Elizabeth's womb leaped with joy. It was not Saint Joseph who knew, it was not the big people who knew, that little unborn child. So we owe the little unborn child deep gratitude for teaching us how to worship Jesus with joy. So let us pray. Let us bring prayer in our life. You parents, teach your children to pray. Teach us in schools and colleges. Teach your students to pray. For prayer gives a clean heart. And a clean heart can see God. The fruit of prayer is deepening of faith. And the fruit of faith is love. And the fruit of love is service. Our sisters and brothers, and now we have also fathers, missionaries of charity. Make a special consecration to God to give wholehearted and free service to the poorest of us. And in that giving, you, all of you, are sharing through your gifts that we continually give efforts to serve and others. 2 weeks ago, I received a letter from a little child from the United States. So small, 8 years old. She was prepared to make her first communion. So before making her first communion, she went to her parents and said, "Mom, I don't want any clothes for my first communion. I don't want anything for my own party or all that. I will make my first communion in my uniform. But please give me the money, and I want to send to Mother Teresa." It was so beautiful. And the little one the other day, after I said this to her, came up after a little while and said, "I have nothing to give you, but I have a piece of chocolate in my hand. I want to give it to you." So beautiful. See the sharing of the joy of loving. There was one time in Calcutta, we didn't have sugar for our children. And a little boy of 4 years old, he heard Mother Teresa has no sugar. And he went home and he told his parents, "I will not eat sugar for 3 days. I will give my sugar to Mother Teresa."
Teresa brought much the same set of words. Mother Teresa brought much the same set of words that she's been bringing. Mother Teresa brought much the same set of words that she's been bringing to the world since she founded her missionary order. In fact, she's urged worshippers here to help her and her sisters with their new project, Shelter for the Homeless.
Yeah, come on.
Mother Teresa brought much the same set of words that she's been bringing to the world since she founded her missionary order.
Well, what you hear? All right, go ahead. I got the drink. This way, no. All right, watch out. Go ahead, Laura.
Mother Teresa brought much the same set of words that she's been bringing to the world since she founded her missionary order. The Earth Worshippers here to help her and her sisters with their new project, a home for those without a home, a place where those who are disadvantaged can turn to in a time of need. I'm Lauren Maddle on Channel 6 Action News in Norristown.
Back up, what are you, back up, come on, you're getting excited.